Okay, so the technology problem that we're going to tackle today is what to do if there are no logon servers. And what happens when there are no logon servers is the computer is trying to log on to a network that's not there. So for example, our computer should be on MCSWLAN when they're connected to Wi-Fi. And for some reason, either a student changed the network or it's just not connecting for some reason. And so no logon server just means that the computer's having trouble connecting or finding MCSWLAN. It could be trying to log on to a network like MCS Public or MCS Guest. And when this happens, it makes the computer's brain just want to do this, which is what your brain's going to do when it's the middle of class and students are saying, "I can't log on, there are no logon servers." So what we have here is just a really quick solution to that problem. The first step is to see if the Wi-Fi is on. The way you can tell is over on the right-hand side of the computer. There are these four indicator lights. The second light down has a little radio antenna, and if the light is not lit up, the Wi-Fi is off, and that should be an easy problem to fix here in just a second. If the Wi-Fi light is on, we're have something just slightly different to do. So if the Wi-Fi is off, we're going to turn the Wi-Fi on by pressing the blue function key. It's that FN in the bottom left-hand corner of your keyboard, and the print screen button, which is in the upper right-hand corner of your keyboard. We're going to press those at the same time, and what that should do, if the Wi-Fi is turned off, that will turn the Wi-Fi back on. And so when you hit that indicator light on the right-hand side should show back up. Now, if your Wi-Fi was on, we're going to do the same thing, except we're going to do it twice. We're going to press the function key and the print screen button at the same time to turn the Wi-Fi off. Then we're going to press it again to turn it back on. And what that's going to do is that's going to reset the network. So if a student had been playing around with the network trying to troubleshoot and they accidentally put it on MCS Public or MCS Guest the day before and then logged off, the computer's going to be trying to log on using MCS Public again, but it's not able to do that. So by pushing that function and print screen at the same time, turning it off and turning it back on again, that resets it to go back to MCSWLAN. And so that's just a real quick way that you can get your computers up and running again if the MCS if you're getting the no logon server error message.